When you want to make a radio, shortwave radio or medium wave, you need an IF amplifier, and often these amplifiers work on 455 kHz. And when you make your IF filter, there are often two or three small IF filters inside these cans, and they have to be tuned to the exact peak resonance of all these three filters, and they must be tuned to exactly the same frequency, and that's often a problem. So for that case you can use this circuit that is a measuring transmitter that works in this frequency band, 435 up to 465 kilocycles, and I've used a normal IF can, this with this type number, and got a try to make, and that was successful, that this tank circuit got into this frequency band. That can mean that you have to open that IF can and solder a variable capacitor parallel to it. There are, by the way, two windings, an in-coupling winding, that's here, D and C. Sorry, that is the outcoupling winding, and here is the incoupling winding, B and A. And between B and A, there is a very small capacitor of, say, 500 picofarad. And that capacitor must be made variable so that you can tune this coil in this frequency band. That has to be done with a counter and a scope. And that's, of course, that's necessary, otherwise you cannot tune your IF filter, because some of them are 450 kHz, some 460, some 455, etc. Of course, with an AM radio, we also have amplitude modulation, and that's mimicked here with the help of this sine wave oscillator that sends in a 1000 Hz sine wave to the base of the oscillator, and that means that the carrier wave that this oscillator strays out is modulated to maximum 30% here, that is, you can align that here, to maximum 30%, and that also means that at the output of your IF amplifier with the AM detector, and when all is aligned well, you will hear a tone of, say, 1000 Hz. And the strength of that tone can also be tuned up, all these three filters or two filters, to the maximum level, and then you know that your IF filter is properly tuned. This is the buffer stage that I made that was necessary to decouple it all, and here you use a small capacitor of, say, 100 picofarad and send that signal in into your IF amplifier. This proved to be the best power supply. I tried a 7812 that didn't work properly, but this worked properly. Pan over somewhat finally, so that all the component values are clearly visible. And here is, for instance, such a IF filter.